No way.
There's no way you would have that drive, right?
That's, I wouldn't have the same drive. No way.
You'd be, but you'd still I, like but, to think you'd still be but, a winner, though,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, but you know what?
You'd figure something out.
I would. You know, I may be a little bit better in school. You know, if I got a different opportunity, I think if I would have got the same opportunity I'm giving my son of being a straight A student, I think I mean, my parents were very artistic. My dad was an artist. My dad was a carpenter. My mother's an artist. I think I have great brains. I mean, shit, look at where I am right now. I mean, the business work I've done already, by all the damage I've done to my brain when I was younger, I'm on great capacity of just learning experience. And I think that my kids have that same opportunity now, but without the drugs around.
Well, you certainly got out of MMA, too, without incurring some, like, speech problems or any of the shit that we're starting to see now from guys.
I see some of the guys now, and it just, like, makes me cringe. And I'm just like, God, man. All those times, all those fights, and you think of guys, you're like, God, I just want you to see you guys stand up and just punch each other in the face. And I was like, okay, I look at boxers.
Yeah.
I mean, for perfect example, actually one of my buddies who I, back in the day, who used to box, Fernando Vargas. And
I know Fernando.
Has he changed?
A lot.
A lot.
A lot.
And I mean, I love him. I mean, he's my boy.
He's a great guy.
Awesome guy, stand-up dude, cool cat.
But there's no doubt he paid a price.
He paid a price, man. I mean, these guys, they're getting their
and
heads
with, it's weird when you know a guy before he pays the price, and then you see the results, and then you go, this is real.
The Trinidad fight was the one that changed everything.
I met Terry Norris once in Vegas. I didn't actually meet him. I was standing next to him, I should say, while he was talking to a fan, and he was, you know, someone's asking him, you know, what's going on with you? Are you going to fight again? And he was talking, and it was almost like it was a joke. I was like, is he drunk? Like, what's going on? And then I realized, oh Jesus, this is why you haven't seen him in years. He's fucking punch drunk.
Yeah, it's just from taking so many blows. And like, is it exciting to put a great fight on? Yes, but to stand there and slug with guys.
Well, it's all, not just that. There's, it's also the gym wars. You know.
That's 100% you're true.
Yeah, and I mean, he got hit too. Terry Norris got hit by guys like Mugabe. Right. You know, when Mugabe was a monster, when he was KOing everybody, he KO'd Terry Norris. It was ugly. Or did Terry? Who did Terry Norris KO? That was like a vicious KO puncher. I'm pretty sure Mugabe KO'd Norris, though. I don't want to say that.
Yeah, I mean, you look at some of the guys now. I mean, guys that Tyson's fought. I mean, they're not all there, man.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Tisha Contreras. I'm with Positive Images. I'm here today with Fernando Vargas, who is the youngest Olympic boxer. Fernando, can you tell us what your title is exactly?
Well, just about a month ago, I just finished winning the Olympic Festival in my second year in a row winning it. Right now, I'm ranked number one in the United States and to go to the Olympics, so I'm really looking forward to that right now.
Yeah, well, that's really good. Can you tell us about your family background?
Well, I come from a strong family. You know, my family, my mom, my dad. I have two little brothers and two sisters. You know, we're really close and that helps me a lot.
Could you tell me where you're from and where did you grow up?
Well, I was born and raised in Oxnard. I've been living there all my life, and I'm really looking forward to representing the United States in the Olympics, bring home a gold medal for Oxnard and my people.
In the immediate aftermath of the fight, Fernando Vargas was not available to be interviewed in the ring. He was taken immediately to a nearby hospital for precautionary examination. But a few days later, our Larry Merchant caught up with Vargas in Southern California.
Fernando, what were your impressions of the fight looking back?
Taking nothing away from Felix Trinidad, I think he's a great champion, a great fighter. His experience, I think the experience that he was talking about was trying to be a little dirty, you know. I hurt him in the fourth round, and when I knocked him down, and when he got up, the first thing he did was, you know, hit me in the balls, you know what I'm saying? And two other times, you know, he hit me again, and you know, what can I say? You know, I take nothing away from him. He was a better man that day.
You had an aura of invincibility about you. You felt that very deep inside you. Is this a shock to you, having come out of a fight that way?
It's a shock to me because it's not something that I wanted to come out, you know, like this. But, you know, it's not the way I expected it. And I don't think if, you know, we would have been playing fair, you know, I would have came out like this. But, you know, I give him all the credit in the world. He was a better man.
Are you afraid that this is going to be perceived as an alibi?
No, I mean, people can say what they want to say, you know. I'm giving him all the respect in the world. I'm saying that he was a better man that night. He beat me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not making complaints or anything, but I'm saying.
Just to go back, when you knocked him down in that fourth mm-hmm. round, did you feel, okay, now I'm there, now I'm getting him, and now I'm going
to
get him
when
out?
When I tried to come with something, I got hit in the balls, definitely. I mean, he had a great game plan, you know. He got me out of my game plan.
What impressed you about him as a fighter, being in there with him?
I think he's, even though, you know, he gets hurt, he can come back. I think that's impressed me.
He's tougher than people think.
I think he's tough. I always thought he was tough, so, you know, that didn't surprise me about him being tough, but, you know, him being hurt and him being able to use his head and knowing, I guess, tricks and in the experience of
so
the game.
So was it premature to take that fight, as many people claimed? Or are you glad you've had the experience, even if it was a hard one?
I'm glad I had the experience, and I just want to show the world that, you know, I'd love to do the rematch, and hopefully he wants it.
So even though the people around you, main events and so forth, feels that you ought to come back on a slower path, you want the rematch immediately?
I want it badly. I just feel that if things didn't happen the way they did, I just feel that I would have been able to be a lot fresher, a lot quicker. I mean, I take nothing away from him. He did what he had to do to win, and he was a better man that night. And, you know, I think he's a great fighter.
So are you going to campaign among your people and tell him you want it right back?
I want a rematch, absolutely. And that's how I feel. You know, hopefully we can do it. You know, I don't know how he feels about it.
If you got up from those knockdowns in the first round, that you'll get up from this in your career?
Absolutely. I think that, you know, I'm a warrior. I feel that I'm a fighter in life and in the ring. You know, when I step into the ring, I give everything I have, and when in life, I give everything I have. So, you know, this isn't going to get me down. I'm looking forward to showing the world that Fernando Vargas can come back from this, from adversity. You know, I'm not a fighter that's gonna just sit down and cry over this. No, I'm gonna go out there and take care of business and go out there and regain my championship.
Having celebrated only his 23rd birthday a few days after the fight, Fernando Vargas can still be expected to have a glorious future in boxing. He's already talking enthusiastically about his next assignment in the ring.
You know, I'm gonna say a few things, and I hope I don't get interrupted by Floyd, the Predator, Mayweather, and then I got Cassius, Captain Crunch, Captain, disgracing the military, wearing such a prestige, wearing that hat, and wears it like Captain Crunch from Gilligan's Island. So let me say something. Look, Shane, right here, saying, oh, you know, it's going to be a great fight, this and this and that. Shane, you remind me of cats back in the day in school that be like, yeah, hey, what's up, dog? Yeah, you know, what's going down? Shake your hand and let me have the back. Oh, yeah, you know, I'll do this, I'll do that. Well, look, right now, we're in Vegas. Let's keep it real. Let's keep it real. Look, let's keep it real. No, you're singing it up now? You think you're singing it up now? Okay, good. You said if you're on my back, because you didn't say it right here to my face. No, okay, you didn't say it in my face. You've never said it at a press conference. So obviously, you haven't said it to my face.
What did you do? I said, I'm not
going
to knock you
out. I'm going to
your face. I'll knock you out.
All right, good. Because we're in Vegas now. Listen. So you're shaking around my mouth, I know I'm gonna knock you out. So I'll say this, I'll put $100,000 down. Put your money where your mouth is. We got $100,000 bet on the side. You knock me out,
$100,000. You knock me out, I got $100,000. Believe me, I knock you out. I just don't like people fronting. Me, I am what I am in front of the world. He comes up and, oh, you know, we're off, and it's gonna be a great fight. It's great for boxing. Man, be real. If you should have knocked me out, let's handle it then. And we're $100,000 down. He knocks me out, he got $100,000. I knock him out. You got Captain Crunch over here. Hey, again, believe me, let's go now. Before they get the opportunity and the privilege to wear a hat like that. He wears it like Captain Crunch or Gilligan from Gilligan's Island.